Hi, I'm Pete Barto. I'm from S&S Worldwide. I'm the Director of Sales.
Okay, Pete, thanks for taking the time to speak to us. We're here today at Dutch Wonderland for the opening of Merlin's Mayhem. Mm-hmm. And Merlin's Mayhem is...
our first family inverted coaster. So we're S&S is really proud. We're really excited to have this ride in our portfolio. And yeah, I think it's going to be a lot of fun for everyone that gets a chance to get out here and ride it.
Yes, so S&S. S&S brings back all kinds of images from really high thrills, exciting stuff, though mostly in a coaster enthusiast, our side. Now, this is not exactly in S&S portfolio so far, so can you tell me a little bit what brought this about? Why did you do this?
Yeah, I think we were looking to really expand our portfolio and you know, get beyond just some high thrill rides. You know, there's so many different needs that a park has, and to be able to serve one more need with a ride like this, or, you know, the ride we debuted at IAPA, the Steeplechase, I think it just spreads our portfolio and makes it so that we're able to provide a lot more opportunities for sales and for the parks and their guests.
Right, and did this come about from S&S, or was it Wonderland approaching S&S saying we want something like this, or was this something you guys were already thinking about and you suggested it to Wonderland? How did that kind of work?
It was actually a combination of both. I mean, you know, we had heard on the street, and we have a product development team, and part of my job is going out and visiting parks and finding out what parts of the industry are not being served with certain style of ride, and we kept hearing that there was a need or an interest in having a family inverted coaster out there from us. So we actually went into engineering and pre-engineering of a family inverted coaster before we actually had a customer. We had a number of customers in mind, but we went into planning, engineering, and design of the ride before we actually took it to market. We debuted it back in 2000, I think it was 15 or 16 at IAPA, but it was right around the same time that we had sold this ride, so they became the first family inverted coaster customer of S&S.
And for those who say, oh, well, look, it's a Pacoma family inverted coaster. Yep. Why is this not a Pacoma family inverted coaster?
Well, for the enthusiasts out there, by color alone, I think it's a it's a match in terms of the paint colors. But we looked actually at kind of what the market offered in terms of family inverted coaster again, because this is not a junior coaster; it's a family inverted coaster, and the kids today, especially the smaller kids, they're not afraid of rides anymore. As soon as they're tall enough, they want to ride the ride. So we wanted to work backwards from, first off, a 39-inch height restriction. And then we wanted to establish maximum G-forces for a rider of that size, a rider of that height, that can enjoy the ride. Because we wanted it that wasn't just going to be a ride that, okay, we're going to take more smaller kids on, and then they're going to go and sit off on another ride. We wanted the entire family to be able to ride it, enjoy it. So I think it's a little more aggressive than some of the other junior coasters that are out there. And again, that's why we actually went with the family title instead of junior, because we wanted everyone to enjoy it.
Right, and then the other thing about it is this basically the standard model and you can then make variations thereof, or was there actually a different standard model and this is a variation of that?
Yep, we actually, the initial design that we came up before talking with Dutch was a compact model, and it's actually, I think, still on our website. It was designed to be compact and self-contained. When we came out to the park, we noticed A, the ground wasn't level, and B, it really wasn't going to quite fit in the area that they were working with. So we went right to custom with it. And now, moving forward in terms of the rides that we've proposed to other parks, they really, most of them are becoming custom designs. There are some portions of here and there that are some carryovers, but realistically, when you're talking about an inverted coaster or a suspended coaster, the thrill level comes into that low ground hugging experience. So in order to be ground hugging, unless you have the exact same portfolio of land here, where, like I said, with about a 20-25 foot drop between where the station is down to the bottom, it's not going to be a cookie cutter off the shelf kind of ride.
Okay, and then as far as then, like we said, you mentioned before the color scheme and everything like that. That is not up to S&S. That's, of course, up to the park, right?
Right.
So the fact that it has this color scheme is not you guys matching with Coma. This is something that the park.
Yeah, the park chose it. I think they, like I said, it's great colors. You know, kudos to the folks at Coma or Chance that I think the yellow and blue, it's a nice color scheme. The yellow track will hide the pollen a little bit in the springtime, like this time of year. So it's a good choice. I think the paint colors work well, but yeah, that has nothing to do with S&S.
And then I noticed the trains, of course, are also different. Mm-hmm. Anything special about the trains that you can let us know?
Absolutely. I mean, that's actually probably the biggest difference between the rides. We looked at a number of different ways to configure these rides, and one of the things that was most important for us was, first off, like you said, dialing back that height restriction. We wanted to be able to get younger riders on there, 3-4 years old, on that ride. So we designed backwards from the restraint out and started with a 39-inch rider to start with. The other thing you'll notice is, unlike some of the other rides on the market, where the seats are individual and separated, we brought those two seats together and put them closer together because, again, dealing with a younger rider and the cognitive ability, if they got scared or concerned, we wanted that parent that would be riding with them to be able to be closer to that child, to be able to just reach across and say, it's okay, you'll be all right. You know, and that's a comfort level. And that was a suggestion that came from the park. I mentioned at the press conference earlier today that a lot of what we did with this ride, we had an idea, but the park had a lot of really good input on operations, on maintenance, on the ride itself, that really made this ride, I think, better. And that's one of the things that S&S has really worked hard to do, is to really, we're not too proud to say we know everything and that this is going to be the ride and here you go, park. We really solicit a lot of feedback from the parks because, quite frankly, and you'll hear it said in this industry a ton of times, 6 months after we sell them this ride, they're going to know more about this ride than we ever knew about it. And now we're taking that feedback, those suggestions, that input, and making those changes for future.
You were riding it earlier. Was that your first time actually riding it?
No. I got a chance to ride it back in the fall, right after we got through the testing and whatnot. So I've ridden it. Probably I've ridden it just about every seat now. But it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. I enjoyed it. First time for my wife to ride it.
Yes, and I guess lives up to expectations.
I think so. I think it's there were some adjustments that we made that I think make it a little more smooth, a little more enjoyable. But for a first time ride coming out of the gates, we're real pleased with it. Really, really pleased with it.
Okay, Pete, well, I guess that's about it. Thank you very much for your time. Yep. Really appreciate it. I enjoyed the ride myself immensely.
Good.
And I can't wait to see how this goes in your portfolio. Hope it's a big seller for you.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a great ride for us. I think, I encourage everyone to come out and ride it. I think you'll really enjoy the experience on it. It's a lot of fun.